Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. As you can see, that's a good size coil. Anyway, she's nice and solid. You can hear a couple of them move. That's fine. Nice and solid. That took a whole bottle of super glue. I used scotch tape there on the corners. That's all right. Anyway, I have adapted the coil winder so we can actually use a better tape and get it all set up. So this came off here pretty easy. Not that hard. And there's our new coil winder. The center piece, if I get my hand to work right here, the center piece right here is the same height as all of this. I did not mess with the center piece at all. And this one here is just a little bit, but this is a little farther down. What I plan on doing is laying the piece across here, just let it lay there and go ahead and wind the wire over it instead of trying to get her through. Because if you look here, it's really not that much room between the pegs and all of that. I don't like it being real weak here. So I decided to just go ahead and leave the centerpiece and just take these down just enough to where I can get that in. And that's going to make things a lot easier. Let's get to winding. Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. We all remember this. Unless you're just finally tuning in, you can check the prior videos. That's the size of the magnet. And the little edges of what we finally calculated needed to come off. And we left the rest of it the same. So we line this up with the magnet. And we can look over here and we can see that it falls just inside that line as planned. And just inside the line as planned over here. It's a tight squeeze. But I'm very happy with it. This took a whole tube of super glue, scotch tape. Yay! Pretty solid coil there. Anyway, so we're fixing to wind some more coils. Just thought you might want to see the finished product and what it looked like. Sweet. I can take these off. I made an adaptation to the coil winder. Basically, I already got attached, so I have to do it from this side. I cut down into here, all the way down to the level of this, and just a little farther down. I'm going to lay a piece of tape down here and across on both sides and start winding my coil. That way when I'm done, I can wrap it. I'm still going to use the super glue. It's the way I learned to do. Well, here's the coil bobbin set up. I got the drill press set down. I kind of tightened it up to where this actually turns a little harder than if it was on a spool, because I want a little tension on it without having to do it on my own. Keeping it coming off the reel straight keeps a lot of excess bends from coming into the wire. And then we're going to stretch it all the way over to here where the coil winder is. I'll be doing the right hand. The left hand will be guiding it in. The first part comes through the side and goes over here. And we wrap it around one of the pegs. Leave about a foot and a half, and then we wind the inside, starting from this side and working over, and then back over again, back and forth until I've got 77 turns. Then we take the rest of it out and wrap it around the thing again. In the meantime, we'll be every so many layers, we'll put a few drops of super glue to hold it all together and keep it nice and tight. Go play somewhere else. Come on. Anyway, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. Happy Mudder's Day. Anyway, got a counter here. I'm going to have to do this one manual. Oop, upside down. There we go. I haven't hooked it up to the winder yet. It's a good thing to do this so you don't lose count. I'm going to let my wife be the counter. I think that's why I married her. Pull the wire. Get this set up. When you see the handle in this position, that's a count, dear. Put you a nice 90 degree bend off in this thing. Set her in the hole. pull it tight, wrap her around one of your pegs, and then we start winding. Press that over to the side, put a nice 90 degree into her. There we go. Now our winding starts. Got tape set up on one. First wrap is going to be the hard part. You want the non-sticky sticky side towards the form. The excess on the outside. Alright, wire's got tension. Pull the tape. And that ought to hold it in place. We go to the second side. Keep everything to the all the way to the side. My finger out of the way. Alright. There we go. That's a full wind. Push this all the way to the side. That's one. Two. Three. Four. Five. At this point, I want to go ahead and push all these wires all to one side. All right, what I did, I took the tape, both pieces of tape, and I stuck them to each other over here. That'll help. Get this to move over. All right, keep going. Really don't want to scratch the wire. If you scratch the wire, you cause a chance of scarring the enamel on here. That's six. There we go. I pushed down my thumbnail. That moved it all over. We're going for the seventh wrap. It's nice and tight. It should move everything over. And that makes seven. Click. 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 Click.
Turns do you do?
77. Don't let me go above 77.